Well, Wednesday night is football night in Northeast Missouri as regional play kicks off in earnest the road to the Show Me Bowl. We start our seven-game odyssey in America's hometown with the Hannibal Pirates. We're set to tangle with an unfamiliar foe coached by a familiar face. That would be Jimmy Tucker, the former Bowling Green boss in his first year at GV. You know what? The Rally Squirrel also made an appearance. Squirrel! Good stuff right there. Let us pick it up early on with the Hannibal defense doing great things right here behind Michael Shivers. First drive for Grain Valley negated by this interception and nice return, though the Pirates could do nothing with that ball offensively. Grain Valley, though, goes back to the air, and this time the play-action passing works just a bit better as it would net Grain Valley the go-ahead opening score from 24 yards out. It's 7-0 at that point. However, the Pirates would tighten up the screws defensively. This is Grant Taylor, mini-me, coming in on the quarterback sack to give his team great field position as Grain Valley would punt it away, and that drive would culminate with this. Joel Schrum from 9 yards away off the little shuffle right there. Good stuff as the Pirates tie the game up at 7 apiece. The defense again big, and again it's Grant Taylor, all conference pick right here on third and goal, snuffing out this attempted Grain Valley drive with a quarterback sack at this point, which forces Grain Valley to settle for the field goal. They go up 10-7 at that point. Hannibal answers from 37 yards away. This is Caleb Beenig just before the half. We're tied up at 10, and that is how we go to intermission. Later, fumbles proved to be the undoing of Grain Valley in the second half. Mr. Borgmeyer with the big hit and the big recovery right here, and that would set up the first of two pivotal Logan Hicks second-half touchdowns. This one from 4 yards away, and it would prove to be the game winner as the Pirates are moving on. They advance tonight by virtue of a victory of 26-17 over Grain Valley. Up next for Hannibal, a showdown with Harrisonville, Fred Bouchard's former old team, as Harrisonville destroyed Moberly tonight. 43-0 is your final. That game will be at Hannibal coming up on Monday night, hosting Harrisonville. Will the Hannibal Pirates, as they look for a measure of revenge against the team that ended their season last year. Class 3 now, Bowling Green taking on Southern Boone. Second half starts slow. Tom Lathrop right here with a 2-yard gain. Remember, Lathrop had over 450 yards rushing in a game this season. Here he is able to burst through for 17 more yards. However, Bowling Green's drive would stall right here. Southern Boone, though, boy, Southern Boone got its mojo on in the second half right here. It's Dylan Becker going the distance for the score to put his team up 22-19. Southern Boone never looks back. They end Bowling Green season tonight by virtue of this victory. Final count in this one, 38-33 in favor of Southern Boone. We move to Class 2 now. Macon trying to bounce back from its first loss of the season, taking on Clark County right here. Joseph Flowers rumbles to the 20 right here and picks up the first down for that Macon Tiger offense, which has struggled of late. In the red zone, the Tigers would go to the air. This pass is picked off, though, however, as Dylan Perrin tries to make something happen, but there's Matt Loader, the interception machine, with a nice pick right here and the nice return to follow. However, Clark County can do nothing with the ball in the first half tonight against that stingy Macon defense. As Macon gets the ball back this time, it's Jacob Lanier with a big catch and the nice run all the way down for the first down at that point. That would set up Mr. Dylan Perrin yet again. He's going to do it on his own, playing with a bad shoulder. Looked a lot better this week. Looked great right here, running with Moxie for the nice touchdown as well to put his team up at that point 14-0. Macon once again would make its way downfield right here, and it would be Henry Walker plunging in for the score to make it 21-0 at that point, though Macon had to weather a furious second half charge from Clark County. Macon is victorious, winning tonight by the final count in this one of 21-13. Up next for Macon, perhaps a rematch with Centralia, who beat them last week. Or could Monroe City pull off an upset against Centralia and Earl Bennett for the first time since 2004? Guess what? Shane Williams was going to have his way in this game tonight. This a 12-yard touchdown to start things off. The Monroe City crowd just amped. The title towners looking for a win, a rare one against Centralia. Centralia, though, bounces back right here. Austin Kincaid in for the short score to tie the game up at 7, but the first half belonged to Monroe City. More Shane Williams, who was a monster. This run of 15 yards puts his team up 14-7 at that point. Monroe City led 17-7 at the half and hangs on for a 24-21 upset win over the number one team in the state, formerly undefeated Centralia, and Dax Dolans. 24-21 is your final, and that means Monroe City is headed to Macon coming up on Monday for what should be a fabulous showdown once again. Good for Tony DeGrave. Great upset for his team tonight. How about Clopton and Blair Oaks going at it in Class 2 in this game? It's got Craiger second in the nation in total yardage among all quarterbacks. Right here he hits Charles Fraction with a catch, the cutback, and the gain for first down against Blair Oaks. This game slow scoring at the beginning. Craiger right here hooks up with, I believe that's Mr. Hurley, for a slant pickup at that point. Problems for Clopton, though, as Krieger is picked off inside the 10. The Blair Oaks Falcons playing stingy defense in a first half that was largely 0-0 going into the second quarter when we left. How about the Clopton defense coming up big right here as Kevin Dotson comes up with the sack? However, despite all of the early struggles for both offenses, this game turns into a slugfest, or excuse me, I should say a shootout in the second half. Unfortunately for Clopton, it goes in Blair Oaks' favor. Blair Oaks wins this game by the final count of 48-32, so Clopton's fine season comes to an end. Let's go down to Class 1 right now. It was South Shelby taking on Knox County. South Shelby scores first out of the gate in this one. Sean Bertrand in from 2 yards out. That puts his team up 7-0. The ensuing kickoff. How about a little onside chicane, or at least a ball that just kept bouncing, and South Shelby would recover, and they would put it to good use. At that point, it was the Austin Hall show in the first half for the Cardinals. Austin Hall in a nice little screen pass. He's going to cut to the edge, get to the margin, and get to the house for the score at that point. Makes it 14-0. We're not done with Austin Hall, not by a long shot. This, my friends, sensational 7 worthy, an 89-yard touchdown rumble to put his team up 21-0, and South Shelby would never look back in this game. The Cardinals win tonight going away, and this one final count was 39-8. Up next for them would be the winner of tonight's Scotland County-Louisiana game, a game that started out in good weather conditions, got worse quickly. Louisiana would dominate this game early. It's Greg Pitzer right here with a nice run, and then it would be Pitzer yet again taking a handoff and finding his way into the end zone from 28 yards away. Great run right there. I almost said Tony Geschwender. Steve Geschwender's team doing nice work at this point to take the early lead. Then it's Mr. Pitzer going to the air. This time he's going to hit Brendan Ross for a 20-yard pass. Scotland County, however, would force a fumble and take it away to end this drive, and that would be the undoing of this particular drive. Scotland County's defense, however, despite all of its good news, he's going to have to get back on the field rather quickly because Scotland County's offense is going to fumble the ball right back Louisiana. And that, my friend, is going to set up Austin Rule for another score as Louisiana jumped out early in this game and hung on to win. As you see, Mr. Rule going in 29-20. So Louisiana travels to South Shelby in the final of our 7 games tonight. That will be again on Monday coming up in playoff play in the second round. One more for you to pass along tonight. Exhibition women's basketball tonight was Western Illinois opening the J.D. Gravina era with a win. It was hard fought. Good second half, though, for the Leathernecks as they knock off Illinois Springfield by the final count there of 76-69.